On the agenda tonight, we're going to be taking a look at Alison Krauss and Union Station performing When You Say Nothing at All. Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. So exactly a week ago, we were taking a look at Robert Plant and Alison, and I've had a lot of requests to take a look at Alison in isolation, but also with an isolated vocal. So that's what we're going to be taking a look at and having a listen to tonight. As always, there's a link in the description below if you want to click on that to watch the performance the whole way through without me interrupting it, because I am going to be jumping in. But let's get into it. So I'm just going to jump in here. Alison's voice is one of those that when I first heard it, I don't know how many years ago now, but I was struck at how accurate she was, just pitch perfect the whole time, considering the fact that she didn't have a vibrato that was anywhere near dramatic. It is so subtle, it's hardly in there at all, which means that she's having to hit every single note dead on because she's just holding that note consistently. And it's great because when we're looking at the pitch graph, it looks exactly how I would have predicted it looked, because she is so consistent. She is just so accurate to within probably maybe 5 cents, if we're talking tuning here, 440 hertz tuning on the pitch graph. That's what we're relating it to. But she's so accurate with pretty much every note that she hits. Just from a performance standpoint, it's interesting in that when we start the intro and we've got the 12 string and the 6 string guitar, really nice sound, they slow down the tempo when Alison comes in with her vocal. So they obviously were pushing the tempo a little bit and then realized they needed to just hold back. But let's get into the performance again, this time just listening to Alison's vocal, because when you listen to it isolated, you get such a deeper appreciation of her dynamic range and where she's placing her voice and how much air is in the sound. Have a listen to this.
It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the door.
There's so much breath in there. Very light vocal cord connection we've got going on here, but just looking at the pitch here, G4, we are pretty much bang on. I mean, we are ever so slightly flat, like I've said, probably to within maybe 2 to 3 cents of just being dead on the line. And you can see here, I mean, slightly flat here, but this is a real voice, so we're always going to be slightly off the note. She's right up there in the top probably 0 0.5% of vocalists pitch-wise, because a lot of singers have vibrato, and this is something that will hide the note that you're singing within the vibrato. And we've seen on these previous analysis videos with other singers who might have a 2, 3, sometimes 4 semitone range that they cover just with their vibrato. So it means that Alison is hitting this G4 dead on, whereas other singers will be hitting the G4, the G-sharp 4, the A4, the F-sharp 4, the G-flat 4, exactly the same note, and F4. So we'd have all of this range that would be covered in vibrato. But because Alison's not doing that, she's got to be so accurate all the time. And she is. The interesting thing about looking at the pitch graph at the same time as hearing the vocal is that you can see, you can't hear, but you can see the tiny variations in the voice pitch-wise that are shown on the pitch graph. Just take this first vocal as an example.
It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart.
Because that just sounds like it's dead on the note all the time. Every single note of that melody seems to be spot on. But when we look at it with the pitch monitor here, you can see that she was dead on, then a little bit flat in this phrase on the G4, slightly flat of the D-sharp 4. And we've got all of this variation in the voice descending through the C4 and this very last one on the B-flat, the A-sharp 3. You can see how seemingly wild it is. It's not wild at all to the ears, but we are looking at this in real detail. So it really does pull into focus how when somebody's voice has been tuned with post-processing and auto-tune, pitch correction, the things that we've mentioned in other videos, how unnatural they look because they are just stuck to the line rather than having all of these tiny variations that you only get with a natural voice. Another good example of that is this first line of the chorus. We'll just have a listen to this in isolation and then we'll get back into the full band performance.
The smile on your face lets me know that you need me.
Just that first line of the chorus sounds absolutely perfect to the ear, but then when you look at the pitch monitoring software and the pitch graph, you can see that that A-sharp 4, we started a little bit flat, then we're dead on the line, then went a bit sharp, then came down again. So you get all of this variation in the voice that is subconscious, and it goes in when you hear it, but you're not aware of it. This is all just expression and emotion, and more often than not, you'll see even more variation than this. It's just the fact that we've got a ridiculously accurate vocalist. She's just got this ability to throw in lines and really quick little, not trills, but little runs where she goes down and you might not even notice it because it's so fast, but even with those little runs she's dead on, hitting maybe a semitone below, then going down to a tone below, but she's really accurate in a split second, so her vocal cords just snap to these positions. I just want to give you guys a quick example of what I'm talking about. Just have a listen to this.
What I hear when you don't.
And, I mean, blink and you'll miss it, but taking it back, let me see if I can play this back in slow motion.
What I hear when you...
It was on when, you can see on our pitch graph, that she actually went up a semitone to the F-sharp 4, then came down again and went to the D-sharp 4 at the bottom here. But this part, I mean, it was so quick. You won't really hear this part where she goes up by a semitone, but it's just a little flick. And she's still really accurate with that little flick. You can see that she's just sharp of the F-sharp 4, but it just sounds great when she does it. That little semitone above, na na na, that, yeah, blink and you'll miss it, but it is so cool to listen to because she does this a hell of a lot. You don't really notice it. You just take it for granted and accept the great voice. But then when you know what she's doing, it's just immense to have that kind of vocal cord flexibility to do it so quickly and accurately.
The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me if ever I fall.
Yeah. stop it there and mark where we got to, because when we're looking at this pitch graph on the screen, I think Alison is one of the most accurate vocalists we've looked at so far. I mentioned in the Karen Carpenter video about hitting maybe three or four lines in a row, and we are at that kind of level here. If I take it back, you can see that her accuracy just holding a note is just off the charts. But as we do go back, the thing about having a natural vocal is that we're never going to have seven or eight just bang on the lines when we're looking at 440 hertz tuning, because that is auto-tune. When you're just listening to a great vocalist, it might be three, maybe four times in a row that they'll hit the lines, but then you'll get the natural variation in the voice and the expression of the voice as well. And they'll be hitting particular notes that don't conform to equal temperament. So it means that they'll be ever so slightly sharp, ever so slightly flat, because that is the best sounding note for that particular note of that chord over the top of the backing. So that's why you'll always get a variation in a fantastic singer. Here, again, flat, but then dead on, we come down, slightly sharp, and then slightly flat, and then dead on. So you're always going to get that variation of being dead on, dead on, dead on, and then either sharp or flat, and then dead on, sharp or flat. You know, it always is going to be with the great singers. I mean, this is just absolutely top level singing from a pitch perspective. She's just nailing the pitch. And with a singer of this level hitting the line three or four times, this is really the top of the top when we're talking about hitting a note tuning wise with pitch perfect accuracy. So when you start seeing another singer who's getting 7 or 8 or 10 or 15 lines in a row, then you know that something is up, that it's been processed digitally, because the human voice doesn't work like that and music doesn't work like that. It's not that strict. But let's get back into it. I love the fact that we've actually got the slide guitar being plotted on the pitch graph. So it's actually picking that up as another voice. I mean, it's within the same range, so I can understand why that's happened. But it also gives you an appreciation of Alison's voice, that the pitch monitoring software thinks that the guitar is close enough to her voice to plot it on the graph. And I mean, when you look at the guitar, I mean, you can see the accuracy of the slide. By the way, when you're playing slide, you are sliding over the top of the frets, not pushing down onto the frets, making contact with the fretboard. You're just sliding across the strings. So look at the accuracy that we've got here just with the slide guitar. Look, he's bang on the D sharp 4, bang on the D 4. And this is really impressive to be that accurate. It means that he's nailing those positions with that slide. But, you know, I mean, this is just a great band all round. But let's continue. When you hold me there, you drown out the crowd. Good example there of being probably quite flat for Alison with the other notes that we've heard so far. And she's just ascending up to the note. So she's got that ear to be able to tell, oh, I'm a little bit flat and I'm just going to ascend a little bit. But by no means was it offensively flat. It was just a little bit flat, because she actually preceded this with a note that was dead on, and dead on here, pretty much dead on. So we've got maybe three in a row, and we didn't get to see this one down at the bottom. So again, maybe if we give her the benefit of the doubt, you could say maybe four in a row, and then we have this flat note, which is always going to happen because it's a natural voice. So let's continue. Oh, Mr. Webster could never define what's being said between your heart and mine. Let me just take that back, because listen to the subtlety. I'm going to hear that all with the isolated vocal. Listen to the subtlety of her voice and the run that she does descending.
Old Mr. Webster could never define.
I mean, it's so like that. My. You know, so accurate, but so light, and there's so much expression in her voice.
What's being said between your heart and mine?
And just the dynamic control there to go from such a light sound to now keeping her vocal cords in exactly the same place, just compressing them a little bit more, and that whole phrase was so even, apart from right at the end where she took her foot off the gas a little bit and then leaned into it again. Her closed chord connection is super clean, and she's not going to get any rasp as she ascends and all that kind of stuff. She just gives you that same tone and quality the whole time, but let's get back into it.
The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me if ever I fall. You say it best when you say nothing.
What a great live performance by the whole band. And it's great that we get Union Station up on screen as well. And I have done Alison Krauss and Union Station on the channel here before, as you guys will know. If you haven't seen that video, you can check that out independently if you want to. But it's great to see the names on screen because of the vocals. Some of the harmonies that were being sung there are being sung by the guys, but they're going above Alison's voice. So you've got not only top level instrumental ability throughout that whole band, but vocal ability in order to take their head voices up that high and be so clean. Because having a harmony vocal behind Alison's voice, you've got to try and match her clarity of tone. And we do get that. And it just sounds great. This is such an easy performance to listen to because of everything matching the backing vocals with the lead vocal, the dynamics of the playing overall. Really nice bass sound as well. If you have got a sub, turn that up to 11 because it's so smooth. The interesting thing about Alison's voice is the way that she hasn't got that vibrato in her voice, but is so accurate. She's probably about as close as you're ever going to get to hearing a stringed instrument in a human voice. And earlier, when the guitar showed up on the pitch monitor, it was interesting because with the guitar, if you do play guitar yourselves, you'll know that sometimes you'll do a hammer-on, sometimes you'll do a pull-off, when you're not vibratoing on a note, just to end a phrase on the guitar. And that's exactly what Alison does with her voice. And we're just going to have a listen to it here as an example.
That you need me, there's a truth in your eyes.
Just there, when she goes, there's a truth in your eyes. And she goes, ah, and she goes down. That's like a pull-off on the guitar that you'll be playing with your third finger. You have your first finger planted, a tone underneath that third finger, do a pull-off, and you go, ah, ah. It's exactly what you'd do on the guitar. So the fact that Alison does this vocally, I mean, the reason that she can even do it in the first place without any vibrato is really impressive from a pitch standpoint, because your guitar is tuned. It's a hell of a lot harder to do this with the human voice, with your vocal cords, managing the musculature, not straining, having control, flexibility, all of these things that you'll need in order to do this with your voice. But Alison's doing it all the time, just doing effective hammer-ons and pull-offs like you would do on the guitar, but with her vocal cords. So this is why it's just great to listen to. If only you could tune your vocal cords like you can with the guitar and make things a hell of a lot easier. I mean, that is auto-tune in a nutshell. But thank you guys for requesting this video for me to take a look at and to look at Alison's voice in a lot more depth. Let me know what you guys think, as always, in the comments section below. Keep those requests coming. And if you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!